Mitch Glasser. If Mitch happened to be a, I heard from the Israel Baseball Association that there was a guy who played on Team Israel in the qualifier who is from Chicago and had gone to Anshe. I think it's impossible, I would have known about it, but I didn't. And so I met, Mitch, and Mitch will tell you his story, but the thing which is, which I want to point out in case he forgets, is that tomorrow, Mitch is leaving for Israel, because what we're working on right now is to get Israel to qualify for the Olympics, to play as, it'll be the first team sport that Israel ever qualified for. So Mitch will be the part of 10 baseball players that have made Aliyah. So the restrictions, the requirements are much stricter for the Olympics than they were for the World Baseball Classic. And so they have to make Aliyah. So he is leaving for Israel on the first time in many years, and he's making Aliyah, and he's going to play for Team Israel. So I'll let him tell his story. I hope you enjoy the movie. I know you will. It's a lot of fun. Thanks for coming.
My name is Mitch Glasser, and I haven't been back to Anshe for quite a few years, so it's great to be back. And I don't want to steal too much before we show the film, but the coolest part about being a part of Team Israel and playing professional baseball for the last, this will be my sixth year playing professional baseball, is most of the teams that I've played on, predominantly Latin American players. You have your Dominicans, you have your Southern boys, you have your Venezuelans, you have your Cubans. And I walk into the Team Israel clubhouse, and all of a sudden I'm surrounded by 28 other Jewish baseball players. And it's a rare thing, and more rare is I've never seen so much chest hair in one locker room. And I didn't say hair in general. There were some good Jew pros, but mostly. So this team, and making jokes, and there's varying levels of Jewish affiliation. There's we joke around and say, okay, if you were a mitzvah, you get 5 points. What's your J score? If you were in High Holidays this year, this is 1 point. Your parents are Jewish, that's a point. And so we go around and say, hey, what's your J score? And so we have guys that are scoring well into the 10s, the 15s, and then there's some guys that have less of a true Jewish affiliation, but maybe it's just more cultural, or maybe they have a grandparent that was Jewish that qualified them to play. But at the same time, we have this camaraderie around us, and we have this identity as being Jews, and we have this identity of being baseball players.